What's up, YouTube? Y'all already know who it is. I don't gotta do too much explaining. It's your boy Andrego, and I'm back. Back for the better. I'm back for a long time.
Yeah, if it's smoke, then I'm coming with it. I ain't gonna hire no nigga to murk it. I'm the one coming to get you. Yeah. My mama hit my phone in the trenches. Like, but don't shoot that pistol. Told my bitches the shit go left, just hit my stash and come and get me. I ain't had a drink with the bitch. I got a bitch out of the body. I'll spin with me. I'm in the
trouble. As y'all can tell by the title, we doing top 5 scams in 2024. Make sure y'all check all the links down in the description. Subscribe to my Patreon and drop more video ideas y'all want to see in the comment down below. Let's get into the video, let's go. And this is for educational purposes only. And the only reason I'm telling you these methods is to show you how not to get scammed and how these people are making a lot of money.
This channel does not promote or encourage any illegal activities. All contents provided by this channel is meant for educational purpose only.
So the refund is scam. I know I done stated this in a few videos, but I want to go over it again and give y'all a way, way better explanation of what the refund and scam is. So companies, they fuck up sometimes when shipping products. Everybody know that. And your main goal with this scam is to convince the company that they fucked up. You feel me? Make them feel bad. Make them feel like you did not get your product. So then you keep the product and get your money back. And you can convince the company that you didn't get your product through a variety of methods. EB, empty box, by saying the box arrived empty. FTID, creating a fake tracking number that's designed to get lost in a trucking and warehouse system, so it looks like you sent the product back. In both of these methods, they will give you your refund immediately, but it may take 3 to 5 business days to reflect back on your account. The second scam, online card. So when you hear people say they just punch sex filth, this is what they talking about right here. So you buy a card from jokerstash.su or Union CC shop. And there are usually these Russians who made a career off of stealing American credit cards on that site. You buy a CC or dump from their site for around $5 to $50. And it don't even gotta be their site, it gotta be a legit trustworthy site. Once they had a right card, they go on a site like SaksFifth or Apple or a gift card site with things like VPNs and proxies. So the security they are using the CC or dump on won't detect any weird activity going on. From there, they purchase the item and they send it to the drop address. And it could be a random address they found on Zillow or abandoned house. Then they walk up to the house and get the package with like a green vest on, or like something that won't make it seem like it's you. Something that covers your identity. They walk up to the house. Once the package arrive, or they sit by the house, wait till the package arrive, and walk to the house with an undercover identity. So people assume that they are legit, and then they collect the package. And it's very simple, but the more money you hit for it, the more easier it is to get caught. Scam number 3, getting people to sign up for iPhones. This scam works by either getting people who are stupid or getting people who are desperate for money to go into Verizon or T-Mobile and buy phones under their name or with a CPN. Then the desperate people will go in there, get the phone, come back and get the scammers the phone, and the scammer usually get a desperate person partial of the money just for helping out. And these phone companies will give a phone to almost anyone. That's how they keep you paying so high every month, because they own your phone, allowing people to pay their bill over time. And then these scammers will take the high-priced phone they got for a deal for like $100 and sell it for $1,000 to someone else or a place that buys iPhones. So when you see scammers placing stacks of iPhones, this is the method that they use to get them. The higher level of this scam is having a person go in with a CPN and an ID that matches the name of the CPN, because you will have more potential of getting more phones because of the higher credit limit. And you could just say you are buying the phones for family members or for workers for your company. Scam number 4, SIM swapping. So how does someone get SIM swapped? So let's say you have $1,000 or $100,000 in a Bitcoin wallet and you are crypto rich. And you got your account set up on two-factor authentication. This means when you're trying to log into your account, you got to get a text message to your phone before you can even log into your account. So in order to get this text message for these scammers to log into your account, these scammers will convince your phone provider that they are you and they will get a new SIM card and call your phone provider and say they're trying to change the old SIM card to the new SIM card that they got in their hand. And this is how they hack Twitter as well. Scam number 5, the tax refund scam. So in order to do this scam, you will need somebody else's information. The SSN, ID, address, and etc. And you can definitely get jail time if you get caught doing this. So what these scammers are doing, they go into TurboTax and they're using other people's info and filing their taxes and collecting stimulus checks using fake work history and other documents. And also on TurboTax, they have an option where you can click have experts file for you, and them scammers will just click that option and then send the fake documents to them to have them file for them. And if they get approved, they will get the money and get it dropped into a drop bank account to cover all the tracks. All right, YouTube, y'all already know who it is. It's your boy, Young Draco. The only thing I ask y'all to do is hit that subscribe button and like all my videos, like including this. Hit me up in on Instagram for more information.
Bye, have a great time.
That nigga trolling us for Reddit, he playing Insta games. He know if we catch him outside, he catching Insta flames. Was getting punched on in the jails, that nigga been ashamed. Hold that ARP steady, that bitch blow grenades. He fell in love with a bitch, now he don't even bend. I said fuck banging a 9, bro, I want the 10. Broski ain't having no motion, I'ma plug him in. Cause he was holding down the jails when they took me in. And he was talking out his lips, now he ain't got a face. Ops dying, use the GoFundMe's, you better click the link. I bet this button go off before you get the blink. A nigga got hit in his head before he got the think. All these blessings coming to me, I just wanna think of law. I hope they got some good pics if the feds indict us. It was dark in BK10, so we had sprung the lighter. No gasoline, them C's blitz and set that boy on fire. Pussy boy, we killer killers and we rob the robbers.
This shit gonna be crazy, man.
Swaggyana, what up, bro?
Shit gonna be crazy. Oh, God. CCK.